Well, let's get the reaction now from Trish Bertram, who was caught up in the chaos at Gatwick on Christmas Eve. Trish, thanks very much for coming along to talk to us. Just tell us about what your travel plans were.
Well, I was actually coming into Gatwick on a flight, an EasyJet flight, that had been delayed for 6 hours coming in, and we kind of knew there was going to be a bit of chaos ahead because I'd been looking on my iPhone, stuck at the other end. But nothing prepared us for the absolute chaos that we found when we arrived. There was a semi-dark terminal, baggage everywhere. People had been separated from their baggage in the baggage hall, so there were cases everywhere. We were then filtered through the customs area, which was dark. There was one member of staff, I seem to recall, I don't think he had a torch, who was sort of saying, go that way, out onto the concourse, where there were hundreds of people, not just trying to get away, but those of us coming in as well. So you had a mix of people arriving and people trying to get away.
So a great muddle, it sounds like.
Terrible.
And you would have then done what in the normal course of events had everything been working? You would obviously have been trying to get your luggage and leave the airport. So what happened with regards to that?
Well, in the normal course of events, I had my train ticket up to Victoria and I would have got myself home, being a Londoner. In this case, there were no trains, so we asked a policeman, because when in trouble, ask a policeman, what do we do? Are there any replacement buses? And he said, nope, there are no buses. There is a cab desk, so we joined the throng queuing up at a cab desk, and we're told there were possibly 4 hours, 5 hours wait for a taxi. And you have to remember, this is about 11 o'clock at night now. And we thought, what do we actually do? It was chaos. There were so few staff, maybe one or two. There was a man on an information desk at Gatwick with no information.
And I understand that you use social media to basically get your friends to come and rescue you.
Yes, thank goodness for social media. I posted a help on my Facebook page, and the spirit of Christmas happily is alive, and two dear, dear friends drove all the way from Kent in atrocious weather and rescued me and my travelling partner.
So what do you think when you hear the boss of Gatwick today, you know, admittedly put his hands up and say, we didn't do as well as we ought to have done? Is that any consolation to you whatsoever?
I did watch the select committee proceedings today, and my view is that by the time we all arrived, the situation went on for hours and hours. So they must have known that flights were still going to come in, EasyJet were still going to try and get people home. So the fact that there was no coordination between the rail services, bus services, Gatwick Airport and EasyJet, complete lack of coordination in my view. And no one to take responsibility, no one to take leadership. I accept his apology, but it didn't help on the day.
Okay, so obviously a lot of work to do there. Trish Bertram, thank you very much for telling us your story.